Fast one to check the not witchcraft.
Grab the cherish.
Her skills are as potent as any sorcery.
God, please never let us go
to each other's behavior by exchanging chemicals.
So that's what I normally do when I get in my car. I have my 10-year plan that I update every year around this time. And a lot of times just overlap with other motivational speakers like Tony Robbins. The calls that I got back from Shark Tank when we were on Shark Tank. And just things that continue to inspire me and show me how close I am getting towards the manifestation of this transformation of achieving a level of success far beyond my wildest dreams. And a lot of times I also mix music with it. I have some CDs where I don't have the music, but then I have some that I do have music. Most of the music, just so you'll know, it is like real hardcore, explicit rap music, or some of my songs from my nephews or some people, because I want to be reminded of what I went through and what I did to myself. So a lot of times when I hear those negative words, they're telling me, you know, what type of person I used to be, or telling me what I need to do to get up, or telling me about the fight I gotta have. That's why, you know, you'll probably never hear me play those songs in public towards, you know, so you can hear them, because those are private songs. They inspire me. I want to remember the darkness. I want to be inspired by those moments. There's also a moment in time when I was going through some stuff with, you know, the success of, you know, achieving our goals with the school and stuff. And I just felt like so many people was out to get me, was out to sabotage what we had achieved. You know, you thought that it was going to be a lot of support and camaraderie, but it wasn't. There was a lot of people turning their backs on you. So I came close to like getting angry, and that was another level of transformation. But instead I took a whole bunch of poems and raps that I had wrote when I was incarcerated, and I began to cut a couple of CDs down in my basement on me just venting and getting out the anger and the frustration. And a lot of times when I'm working out, I listen to that. I'm reminded of those things. You know, I once again, transformation for me is changing the things that were a part of insanity and not repeating them. You know, if it brought about bad, negative results, I needed to change that and replace it with positive, inspirational things that allow me to grow and go to another level. So when I'm listening to these 10-year plan, I just needed to be fit into my subliminal over and over and over and over. Excuse me. And it's like muscle memory. You'll get to a point where you don't even have to consciously think about it. It becomes a subconscious manifestation day to day, and a reminder, and, you know, also an instinctive thing that'll keep you on the right path. That's what's really, really important. That's why it's important for me to surround myself with positive things, things that complement where I want to be. You know, that's why also you got to be careful when people begin to tell you what you can't do and what you know, doesn't make any sense. I mean, it's really good to, you know, collaborate and talk and consult with other people. But you got to remember, at the end of the day, you only remember where you came from, what your story is, what you have achieved, what motivates you, what your purpose, what your desires. I mean, that's really important within self. And that's what it is for me. That's why I listen to my 10-year plan. I listen to the things that inspire me and keep me pushing and reminding me of where I come from. You know, it's like at one time I remember getting caught up in the other people's interpretation of success and wealth. And I had to remember to hold up, man. This was before it even became a manifestation of goals or, you know, even the life I'm living today. This was just a little kid in the Lafayette Projects dreaming and hoping that he could one day meet Bruce Lee, you know, or want to be like Bruce Lee. And how greater is it for you to achieve levels of success where you get a chance to work with your hero's, you know, daughter, playing yourself on a TV show, or working with Chuck Norris and working with some of the greatest martial artists that was in magazines, even being on the cover of the magazine. Don't let nobody diminish your achievements. That's what's really important. And I got to work on it, because I think a lot of times for myself, I'm starting to catch myself going towards people, consulting with them and talking to them, and they are diminishing things that were impossible in my life at one time. And because I'm strong, you know, I walk away and feel like, oh man, you know, and we are we really going down this path? But why am I volunteering myself for that sort of misery? I wouldn't do it with a hustler that I came up with back in the day. I wouldn't put myself in an environment with people that did all the bad things I'm doing. So why do we find ourselves accepting that it's okay to do it with people that might have good educations, it might be in positions of power, it might be positive people, it might be leaders, it might be masters of martial arts, or, you know, just good people, good, you know, people that we thought follow good orderly directions. I'm saying that for me, I gotta, you know, because that's extra work. You don't put extra work on, man. You don't keep volunteering for unnecessary misery. You understand what I'm saying? You gotta, you know, it's already hard with the battle inside your head. So why would you keep volunteering? I'm saying bam for the unnecessary stuff. Hold dear to those things that compliment you and empower you, like my 10-year plan.
In the 21st century, presentation literacy should be taught in every school. Indeed, before the era of books, it was considered an absolutely core part of education.
So I'm going to leave you with that. My 10-year plan on my audio tape, that's what I listen to. Don't listen to the radio. I control my destiny. Always have. Until I made choices to give up. Can't do that anymore.
Art of speaking effectively.